Okay, let's do some practice today. I'm just going to practice some exercises, some etudes by Czerny maybe, or some sight reading, some waltzes, anything goes. So yeah, let's get started. Oh, hello, Beltinum. Welcome. Thank you. Welcome to the stream. I hope you enjoy. I'm doing some practices today, like exercises and stuff. Thank you for following. So I'm trying to like improve my finger technique so I can play smoother and faster, especially the left hand. It's the hardest left hand. Okay, let's continue to the next exercise. Even after years of study, it's still like very hard to have the right hand play very smoothly and like consistently. Oh, you played piano as well? Oh, I see. That's nice. Like, my biggest problem is like my left hand is still not like flexible enough, and I still can't really play like some passages, some runs quite consistently. Like sometimes the timings are off and stuff. Thank you. So I've been playing these etudes, exercises for like a few days, and I definitely felt like there are some improvements in my technique, even though I'm still not that far yet. But yeah, I do feel like there are some improvements. So I guess that's a good thing. Yeah, and if you practice the right thing and with the right way, I guess they're much better than just trying to play things randomly or just playing songs that you've already mastered, yeah? Like mindless practice is also not good, like you won't get anywhere, right? Oh, that's nice. Like, Like if you have a fun teacher that can like give you ideas and teach you stuff in a good way, it's like a blessing. I also had a very good teacher, like, I think it was more than 10 years ago. Yeah, I've played since like probably maybe 20 years ago. Yeah, around that time, 15, 20 years ago. But I took a few years break. Like I stopped playing piano for like a few years before coming back just last year. Yeah, there. But I'm not that good yet, unfortunately. But yeah, here I am. I'm practicing to be better. I'm planning a virtual concert, like charity concert, around maybe the end of this year. Like it's going to be a free concert, but yeah, it's for a charity if there are any donations given at that concert. So yeah, I hope it will be a good one. Thank you. Yeah, I do. I wish I can give like a yearly concert, something like that, and play something big, like piano and orchestra stuff like that, maybe for 1 hour each, something like that. It would be fun. And of course, it's going to be free. Everyone can watch. It will be open to anyone. Okay, maybe one more time that for that exercise. Okay, let's try. This part is really difficult to do right. Thank you for following. How do I pronounce it? Ta98? Yeah, thank you for following Ta98. Oh, Ume, thank you. Thank you as well. Thank you for following. Welcome to the stream, Ta and Ume. I hope you enjoy. I I always get that rundown wrong. Okay, so let's try again. Okay, let's try from the beginning one more time. So yeah, they say C major is the easiest key to play and read. No, it's not. C major is the hardest key to play. That's what I think. So like B major is quite hard to read because it has like five sharps, but actually it is one of the easier to play. Like it is one of the easiest because how it is like how it is shaped with the hand. Like it fits your hand shape. And there are quite a few, like, how do I say this, landmarks you can use when you do jumps and stuff. Jumps, arpeggios, something like that. It has landmarks with the black keys. That's why it's easier to play, but it's quite harder to read. But for C sharp is actually very awkward to the hand because it's all in white keys and it's flat. And when you do jumps, you can't like have landmarks. Like when you jump in the black keys, like You can aim where you want to jump to, but C sharp, it's all wide. Like, and when you do arpeggios like just now, broken chord arpeggios like this, there's not really any landmark you can use to put your hand in. Like, you just have to try. So like in this least etude, it's all just arpeggios up and down, and it's all in the wide key. It's very hard to do. Very hard to get right. Okay, next exercise. I get your pun now. I've just realized it's a major challenge. Yeah. That's a good one. I love a good pun, and you made a good one. Oh, hello, multipurpose. Thank you. Welcome to the stream. I've been listening to Yun Chan Lim. It's like he's like breaking the classical world. Like everyone is shocked at for him to win the Van Cliburn. Yeah, for him to win the Van Cliburn. And I heard his Rachmaninoff piano concerto, and I loved it. I understood why he won the gold medal. But I also love Evgeny Kisin. And I've loved his playing like ever since forever. But yeah, my new jam is Yun Chan Lim. He's still 18 and he's just won the Van Cliburn. And that's crazy. I also love Arthur Rubinstein for his Chopin interpretation, and also I've been practicing Edvard Grieg's piano concerto, and I listened to Rubinstein's interpretation, and I loved it more than the other interpretations. Like he didn't play too fast. Like I think it was the right tempo to play. Thank you. Yeah, you should definitely watch Yun Chan Lim's Raktri Piano Concerto sometime. Like, it was really crazy. And he's not just playing fast. He plays it perfectly. Like, the musicality and stuff, he gets it right. Yeah, it's actually just how you play, how you like decide how you play the piece. But it sounds cool, yeah. That was a hard exercise, and a long one too. Yes, Journey! Hello, Piano Souls! Welcome to the stream! Yes, it's Opus 299. Correct! I'm visiting this old book, like it's been a while, like it's been years since I last touched this book, since I last touched the Opus 299, so I'm just doing it again now, trying to improve my technique again, since I just came back to piano last year. So yeah, I'm trying this book again as a complementary practice. Oh, list. I can play some list. I'll play the third etude from the Transcendental Etude. It's actually like my best piece for a list, I think. Like, oh, I'm also practicing Mozart, yeah. I'll play Mozart as well after this. Thank you. I also love Liszt, but his pieces are just very hard. Yeah, I love harmonies du soir. I wish I can play harmonies du soir, but it's very difficult. Like I've tried, but it's hard. Also, the fingering and the arpeggios are very, very wide. Yeah, it's very difficult. Thank you for following Piano Souls. I forgot that part. That's the only two Liszt etudes that I can play. The others I can just play like excerpts of it. Oh, it's called Piano VFX. I downloaded it from Google. I forgot where. You can probably just search Piano VFX and it might come out. Yeah, but I downloaded it from Google. And it uses MIDI connection. So yeah, it's easy to set up and things. Hello Piano Faraday, how are you? It's been a while since you last posted a video, I think. Oh, I haven't. It didn't appear in my feeds. I'll check it later. Oh, I forgot K280. I forgot which one that is. Thank you. Well, that's great. I'll be waiting. I've been fine. Mozart is one of the hardest to play for me. Yeah, Mozart is really hard to get right. This is another hard least piece. Thank you. this part is really hard to play clean. The fingering is just tricky here. So yeah, that's Liszt's Liebestraum, Dreams of Love. That's one of my favorite pieces from Liszt, actually. But yeah, that chromatic third run is very difficult. Like, I can do it with one hand, but two hands, it's gonna take a while. Yeah, it's very difficult. Also, I've been working on the Mozart piano concerto. Thank you. The reason I touch the tourney again is because I want to fix my Mozart. I want to play it clean.
Thank you.
So yeah, that's the Mozart concerto I am practicing right now, and I wish to play it in the concert soon. I guess that's, you know what, I guess that's it for today's practice. I will be streaming again tomorrow, but tomorrow will be a gaming stream instead of a piano stream. I might stream piano again or music stuff, maybe the day after tomorrow, but we'll see about that. So I guess thank you so much for everyone who has come to the stream. I hope you all enjoy my practice session today. So yeah, we'll see you soon. Thank you so much. Goodbye.